Discussing the death, what actually death is and how does it occur?
Of the heart, number one, and number two is the stoppage of the respiration or respiratory system, and number three is the activity of the brain. If any one of these three things occur, that means the death has taken place. The person is no longer in this world. So that is the basic definition. Then it says that an individual who has sustained either the two categories of legal death. Legal death होती है जिसे हम forensic कहते हैं general sense में, जो आपने देखा अक्सर सोचा होगा crime के related जो होती हैं चीजें होती हैं known as forensic. The categories of legal death and that is determined by irreversible cessation of breathing. Then there can be another case of cardiopulmonary death. Cardiopulmonary death is the death which is related to heart as well as the lungs. And that is, again, it has to be determined. Then the doctor says these two body elements are not functioning. That means the death has taken place. But then when we talk of the deaths before, or death has explained in Islam, or the architecture of death explained in Islam, we look at what happened in the case of other religions. For example, what happens when somebody dies belonging to the Jain religion or the Buddhist religion, what happened in the case of Christians and what happened in the case of the Zoroastrians. So that is also important to know. Now, in case of the Jains and Buddhists and Hindus, obviously they burn their dead bodies. But when the death or the person who has died is an infant, for example, he's 4 or 5 years old, then he is not dead body dead. Only generally they are burnt. Nevertheless, we can say that in the case of the juniors, they do not burn the junior, but they burn elders. And there is another category amongst the Hindus that if a very, very old person dies, for example, person is 80 years, 90 years, 100 years, and he's not dying, and the people are looking, people around him, उसके रिश्तेदार जो हैं वो दुआएं मांग रहे हैं कि अल्लाह मियां इसकी मुश्किल आसान करे, जैसे हम भी वी प्रे व्हेन द पर्सन गेट्स वेरी ओल्ड एंड ही इज अनेबल टू मूव, ही कांट गो टू बाथरूम, ही कांट डू एनी अदर देन वी से वी प्रे टू गॉड, अल्लाह मियां इसकी मुश्किल आसान कर. बट ये जो दुआ है दो तरफा दुआ है, यानी अल्लाह ये कहते हैं अल्लाह मियां इसकी मुश्किल आसान कर और हमारी भी मुश्किल आसान कर, बिकॉज इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट to look after a person who cannot move at all, is on the bed at the time, or at all the time. So dono ki mushkil asaan ho jati hai. So in case of the Hindus, when a very old person dies, so they celebrate it. Wo bade khush hote hain. And I have seen in my childhood when there was a janaza, let's call it janaza. When there was a janaza of a very old, very, very old Hindu, to uske aage band baje baj rahe hote the. It was celebrated that the old man has died, and this custom continues. And then while I was studying in Edinburgh for my doctoral degree, I came across, I saw a documentary on BBC. Normally what they do is they take the dead body to the river bank. Normally it is the Ganga's bank, river Ganga's bank, and the body is burnt there normally. Now this is not possible in case of every death. Why it is not possible in every death? Because the wood has become very expensive, and the poor people cannot afford to buy that much wood to bury the dead body. So that has become a big problem. So that is what is happening in this. The other religion, what we do is the Christianity. They simply burn the dead body. So they bury dead body also. There are two methods. Christianity में आप देखेंगे बड़े बड़े graveyard हैं. There are two important graveyards in Lahore also. One is adjoining the Lahore Gymkhana, which is also visible on the back of the Gymkhana on Jail Road. And then there is another one on the Ravi Road also. So वो भी दफन करते हैं, but often in Europe or other country they have started burying the dead body because they say they cannot afford that much land for the dead. And at the same time, if the graveyards keep on expanding, then there's no room will be left for the houses of the people. So that is another type. They burn it for the sake of saving the space, and then the whole process is very simple. Take the dead body to the incendiary place, jahan dead body jalai jati hai, put the in a few hours. And these were some of the reasons and one of the symptoms which ultimately lead to death of a person. But then we have a very important question which is dealt in Quran also, but in Bible as well. That Bible says that Cain was the firstborn, was the farmer, the two sons of Adam al-Islam. One was Cain and other was the Abel. Isko hum Kabil or Abel kehte hain. So the first one, the Cain, was a farmer, while his brother was a shepherd. The brother made sacrifices to God, each of his own produce. Dono ye baat karte the, lekin unfortunately jo Abel ki baatein thi, wo kabul hoti rahi. But the Cain's ibadat didn't work, so he got little prejudice against his brother. So the concept of hasad started right from the beginning of human civilization. And so ultimately, out of their greed or anger or hatred for his brother, Cain ultimately killed his brother. Now when he killed his brother, the question was how to get rid of the dead body, where to hide it. So that was the big issue. So this is a picture from the old historical books produced in Europe. The Cain is taking his brother to the forest where he intends to kill him. And then Cain is portrayed as sinful. Throughout the history of Cain, he is portrayed as a sinful, committing the first murder by killing his brother after God rejected his offering of produce but accepted Abel's sacrifice. So this has two aspects. One is the prayer and the second is the sacrifice or the element of sacrifice. And they have every element of sacrifice or sadaqah or zakat always bear fruit. That is obvious from the various surahs in Quran or various ayat in Quran, particularly when we refer to Surah Al-Muzammil. In that, God also says that if you are giving something in zakat, actually you are not giving zakat to the poor person, you are giving zakat to Allah. And Allah, for Allah, that zakat is like a loan. Allah is taking loan from the humans, and Allah will return this loan many times larger in number to the humans who has given the sacrifice. And that is the importance of giving in the way of Allah. And that is what is described here also. This is the other picture, the biblical narration, and this man has killed his brother with this little axe. And that is what has happened. And then Abel, the first murder victim, is sometimes seen as the first martyr, while Cain, the first murder. So Abel, that is also considered as the first martyr. Pehla shaheed, aaj shaheed jo hai, that is the Abel. And this is also a picture from the ancient books. This is actually a diptych. And when you say diptych, what is a diptych? Any idea what is a diptych? Aap art student to nahi hai, lekin architecture mein bhi thoda bahut to pata hi hona chahiye ki what is a diptych. Diptych is a picture which has two pictures in it. And triptych is a picture which has three pictures in it. So aapne dekha hoga sometime, the Japanese paintings are in three parts. Ya teen paintings ko jod ke latkaye to then it is one painting. So they are known as triptychs. Or agar do pieces ho to triptychs. Now in this case, in this diptych, there is a brother Abel and this is a Cain. And this is the shepherd, obviously, and this is the agriculturist. And then with the help of this club or whatever it is, whatever weapon is this, he is killing his brother. This is yet another picture from the ancient treatises. And then this is the picture of the Abel. Abel is depicted with a halo. That means he is very sacrosanct, is very important, he is very holy in the eyes of the people. and the parents are crying over the dead body of their son. And this is a picture from a very historical book, I think the Book of the Kings, which is known as the Shahnama also sometime. And from the evolution of the human, this picture depicts that this is the Kabil. And he's, when I say the question was how to dispose of the dead body of his brother, that was his question. And he was not getting any answer, couldn't think of any solution. Then he saw that a crow is trying to bury his fellow crow. So this crow digs a small pit and buries the dead crow into that pit. And so from this idea, he got the idea that he should also dig a pit. And in that pit, he should deposit the dead body of his brother. And that we can conclude is the first grave which was built on earth by humans. So this incident has many a thing. That is the first murder. It is also the first martyr, and it is also the first grave on the earth, three incidents all together. And this is the grave of Abel or Habil. This is in Syria, very, very long one. Very long grave, about 9, 10 yards in length. But do you think people were of that size at that time? What is your opinion on that? Were they so tall?
Yes, sir. Sunato.
Yes, sir.
जी क्या क्या बताया आपने फिर बताएं?
सर सुना है कि लाइक उनकी हाइट्स लंबी होती थी पहले इंसानों की.
सुनते तो हैं, but if you look at the mummies, जिनकी बात शायद आपसे हो रही थी last time, mummies की बात. Mummies, you had dead bodies of the pharaohs, Yosukat ke log jo the. And that history goes back about 7,000 or 8,000 years ago from now. So, agar 7-8,000 saal pehle jo unke dead bodies agar aap dekhe hain, to maine to unke dead bodies dekhe hain, duniya ke bahut se museums mein hain. So, the size of just like us, even smaller than us. So, but still, we believe, or some of us believe, that at that time the people were very tall. May be right or may not be right, but there is no evidence. But there are graves like this in Pakistan also. For example, if you are traveling from Lahore to Wazirabad or Gujarat, when you are bypassing Gujarat on the old trunk GT road, you will find the signboard saying that the no gazon ki kabre. So that means those graves were nine yards long. Also, if you go to Azad Kashmir via Bimber, also, you will find a number of graves which are 9 yards long graves. But I saw the grave of Eve, Mother Amahua. That is also a very, very long grave. And talk about that also, show you a picture as well. So Abel is buried in the Nabi Habil Mosque of Damascus in Syria. The Nabi Habil Mosque is the name of the mosque, and it is in the city of Damascus, which is Damascus. Muslims are frequent visitors to this mosque for ziyarah. The mosque was built by Ottoman Wali Ahmed Pasha in 1599, and it is said to have 40 mihrabs. So there may be authentic evidence or not authentic evidence, but then, nevertheless, we do not know that when the grave was built in 1599, where from he was able to detect that this is the actual grave of that Abid. So we are not sure, but anyway, it is believed that the grave, which was created by Ottoman ruler in 1599, is supposedly the grave of Abel. And this is the grave of Eve, that is Amahua, which we could say, I saw this grave myself while I was in Jeddah. So this is also a very long grave, maybe 9 meters or 9 yards long. And then the Eve is the name in English, but in Urdu, in Persian or in Arabic, we call it Hawa. And Hawa is also known as Jinn. Jinn means the mother of humankind, mother of us, all of us. So when we say mother is in Arabic is the Jinn. So the name of the city of Jeddah is actually after Jinn. And if you go to Saudi Arabia and go to the city of Jeddah, the Arab people or the Saudis don't call it Jeddah. They simply say Jeddah. So actually word is also Jeddah. It has been mispronounced by us as Jeddah. So Jedd simply means mother, and because the city is after this mother, so it is known as Jiddha. And this map is only there to show you some of the areas where most of the graves of the prophets and holy men are located. And this area is full of the graves and graves and graves. But when you say the grave, it is not grave in the modern sense or grave in the sense that we have today. For example, if you go to a graveyard, we see graves which are in a small mounds, chote-chote mounds bane hue. Actually, the graves in ancient period or olden period, there were no mounds. They were just flat surfaces, and only at side there used to be stone and nothing written on the stone, just an ordinary stone on the head side. And that meant the body is lying on this place, and the stone is indicating the head side of the dead body.